This is the fourth webinar for the Pixel project, and it is going to present the PEI, which is the port environmental index we're using in our platform. This is one of the probably the most important innovation we're having in our project. And this is the first out of two webinars we're going to have about the PEI. And it is going to be presented by Mrs. Theodora Milosevic, who is an engineer for MEDRI, from Stepan Plisic, who is also an engineer for MEDRI. MEDRI is Faculty of Medicine of the University of Rijeka. Then Mr. Orestes Tsolakis, who is a civil engineer for the Hellenic Institute of Transport for the Center of Research and Technology, Hellas. And then we're going to see some showcase, some visualizations from Mr. Ignacio Lacalle, who is from the University of Valencia. He's a researcher. And the university, the Polytechnic University of Valencia, is also the project coordinator for our project. So without any further ado, I'm giving the floor, I'm passing the floor to Theodora, who can start with her presentation. Theodora, good morning.
Hello, good morning. I will share my screen. So as Leonida already said, my name is Theodora. I'm a researcher at the University of Rijeka Faculty of Medicine. And today MEDRI was the work package leader for the development of the Port Environmental Index. And today we will show you the results from the intensive work of all the project partners from Pixel. But first, as Leonida already said, I would like to draw your attention to the previous webinars. There are three of them in total. The first was about the Pixel project. The second was about the science behind Pixel and the user cases, scenarios, models, algorithms, and the important activities scenario model. And the last one was only 2 weeks ago, which was about the Pixel platform and showcasing the platform. More information about this you can find on our web and our YouTube channel. So a little bit about the content. I will start with the basics, what is the PEI and what is the need for it. And then we will talk about the significant environmental aspects and environmental key performance indicators. A little bit about the Pixel ports and how the PEI fits in. What are the main obstacles for the development and in using PEI? What are the current status of environmental performance assessment in ports today in Europe? A little bit showcasing the PEI visualization, a short and simplified overview of the PEI methodology, and some concluding remarks. So to start with the basics, first I would like to say that today already exist several methodologies for the environmental assessment, that they are mostly qualitative and not quantitative. So there was a need for a standardized, comprehensive, and IoT-based method, and this is why we created the PEI. PEI is a quantitative composite index, which is based on aggregation of individual indicators, which are called environmental key performance indicators. And they present a way to form the foundation for the future improvement of the ports. Those eKPIs are carefully normalized, weighted, and aggregated in a single metric, which is the PEI. And we identify those eKPIs using the significant environmental aspects, which we'll be talking more a little bit later on. Another important thing about what would I like to mention about the PEI, we divided it in three, or better said, four subcategories, sub-indexes, based on the entity and the environmental impact source, which are the port authorities, the port authority environmental index PAE, the terminal operators, the terminal environmental index TEI, ships, which is the ship environmental index, and one index which will include all of them, it's all. Well, now Stepan will talk a little bit more about the significant environmental aspects and the key performance indicators. So I will go outside and Stepan can share his screen.
Theodora, excuse me for interrupting. Before we continue, I would like to tell to all the attendees that if you want, you can ask questions. One way to do that, of course, you can always intervene. You can also raise your hand. There is a feature on the top right corner of your screen where you can raise your hand, and in order not to interrupt the presenter like I did now, and you can it will be logged in that you want to ask a question, and I will pass the floor to you during the Q&A session. Thank you very much.
Excuse me, can you see my screen with the presentation?
Yes, Stefan, well, we're seeing you, yeah, now. Yes.
Okay, because I was not sure if everything is working correctly. So you're seeing everything fine. So as my colleague has said, I will now say something more about the significant environmental aspects. As Theodora has said, significant environmental aspects are those aspects that are, well, significant and relevant for our indicator. And so how do we determine those aspects? We have described the procedure in several steps. Here are eight main steps, with the first step being the identification of port operations and activities, especially those port operations and activities that have a significant impact on the environment. Once we have listed port operations and activities in the port, in our ports, we must assess the severity and probability of a negative impact on the environment of those operations and activities, and also which of the impacts are significant and which are not. In order to assess the significance, we use two criteria, two bigger criteria. The first one is a legal criteria, because if the aspect is regulated by law, it is an important aspect even without looking at any other criteria. And if it's maybe not regulated by law, we have additional criteria. And that criteria is done by consulting the existing researchers on the subject, and also by consulting the opinions of people, both experts and both public opinion, because both of those are relevant. Of course, it is sometimes hard to create own opinion polls, but enough of those opinion polls are already available in the published reports, literature, scientific literature, and technical literature and other. And based on those two criteria, we evaluate the significance of each of the environmental aspects that we have previously related to port operations. And we have some kind of final score, and based on which we determine if the aspect is significant or if it is not significant. So after all this work, we have concluded that the following six environmental aspects are the most important one in ports as a general. Five of them are the same in each port, that is emissions to the atmosphere, or air pollution, however you prefer to call it. The second one is wastewater emission, both technological, sanitary wastewater and stormwater and others. There is also a solid waste production, noise pollution and light pollution. Noise and light pollution might not be regarded as a typical pollution by some, as there is not a pollutant that is in the classical sense of the word, but it is a pollution nevertheless. And the last of our aspects, odor pollution, is very specific because it can be completely insignificant in some ports, such as our pilot ports, which basically don't consider odor to be a significant aspect, but some other ports, mainly those that deal with cattle transport or fishing ports, they might regard odor even as the most important aspects, or especially if they are located in populated areas. So once we have determined those significant aspects, we must also identify indicators which represent our aspects. So in the choice of our indicators, those indicators form the basis for our composite indicator. We had five criteria. The first one is that an indicator must be significant. That means that it must represent the aspect that it is chosen to represent. For example, CO2 is a representative indicator for air pollution, but it is not a representative indicator for a significant indicator for noise pollution because it's not related to it. And also it is, if we see what is relevant for some activities, not everything is related to every activity. And so it must also be representative of the port, because some indicators might be too affected by outside influences. And we don't want that, because if our indicator takes it into account traffic in the city or something like that, it is not representative for port and it can result in very, very wrong results. Also, it must be measurable in real time. It is ideal to use sensors for everything, but sometimes it is impossible, but it must be measurable in some reasonable time. And it also must be quantitative. We can't have some kind of descriptive indicator, something like that. We must have a numerical value in order for indicator to be useful for us. And it also must be useful for our purposes. Just to show you some examples of those indicators in order to make it clearer for you. So different eKPIs represent different aspects and also different sub-indices or entities. Of course, not same indicators can be used for air pollution and wastewater emissions, but also different indicators can be used for same aspects, but for different entity. Also, each of those indicators I was telling about is measurable using a different approach. So, as it is written here, we can use sensors, we can use web forms, we can even use approximations when nothing else is available. So, what are those eKPIs? The first example, as you can see, we have provided eKPIs representing air pollution that is caused by ships. So we have indicators such as CO2, NOx, particulate matter of different sizes, SO2, and the others. Our next example is eKPIs representing solid waste production of port authorities and terminals. Here we actually have a case where eKPIs differ based on those if it is caused by port authorities and terminals. For example, for terminals, we have all of these three listed indicators, such municipal solid waste, inert waste, and hazardous waste. But for example, for port authorities, we don't have any hazardous waste. Hazardous waste transport and handling is done by terminals, and port authorities, which are mostly an administrative entity, they usually don't deal with dangerous goods. So indicators for port authorities are only municipal solid waste and inert waste. And also the third example are eKPIs representing noise pollution in the whole port. As my colleague has said, we have different three different entities plus some indicators that are impossible, aspects and also their indicators that are impossible to divide by those entities, and noise is one of those. For noise, we have two indicators, that is LDEN or L day, evening, night, which is calculated based on day, evening, and night noise levels, and the other is L night, that is calculated only for noise during the night. Those are basically direct measurements during the night, not calculated. And for light and odor, we have only one indicator. It is either light or odor, as you can see in the picture below. Okay, so I was telling something about the significance assessment and also choice of indicators. What we must also have in mind, that each port is unique and each port has different main activities and different priorities. So we had four pilot ports, that is Port of Piraeus, Port of Thessaloniki, Port of Bordeaux and Port of Monfalcone. And each of them has listed the different priorities at the beginning of this project. So we have Port of Piraeus, that is a large port that is mostly oriented towards tourism. Cruise ships are one of the main pollutants here. And they are also mainly interested in noise and air pollution. And due to their location, that is more or less in the center of the city of Piraeus, there are also...
Stepan, may I interrupt for a second?
Of course.
The port of Piraeus, which is the biggest port in the Mediterranean Sea, is mostly a trade port. The pilot we are using in Pixel is tourism-oriented, and it is related with the cruise shops, with the cruise and passenger ships.
Yes, of course. I was referring to that.
Yes.
Because we are mostly dealing with cruise terminal, yes. For our needs, it was mostly related to tourist, let's call it, section,
exactly.
Part of the port.
Exactly.
And so due to the location, they also have a significant port-city interaction. So logically, noise and air pollution are the most important environmental aspects. And they're also interested in vessel planning impact on this pollution. And Port of Thessaloniki, it is a much smaller port than Piraeus, of course. They are mostly interested in the impact of cargo handling operations and trucks. And their location is, let's call it, similar to the Port of Piraeus. So there is also a significant port-city interaction. And of course, they have listed noise and air pollution also as the main environmental aspects. Port of Bordeaux, for example, is mostly interested in energy consumption or use of green, let's call it green energy, because they are the only port, as much as I am informed, they are the only four of our only one of our four pilot boards that actually produced its own electricity using solar panels, and they are also interested in how to measure the reduction of those negative impact because of their own technology. And of course, there is a port of Monfalcone that is especially interested in how the traffic congestion and parking occupancy, where we include the planning and the automatic booking system, dangerous transport alert, and similar things, how it will affect their environmental performance. So it might seem I am going a bit too far from the subject, but I am just wanting to show you how different each of these ports are, and that during our assessment of the significance of our aspects, that we must create an indicator that is relevant for all of those ports, and not only for those ports, but for every port that exists. And I think we managed to choose the most relevant aspects, but it was a quite complicated process. Okay, so what are the main obstacles or main issues, however you want to call it, during the creation of the PEI? Okay, the first one is that the PEI should be available for use in all ports, as I have said just a moment ago. It should be available for every port. It can be as large as, I don't know, Piraeus, it can be smaller than Monfalcone, but it must be available for use in each port. And also it must be available for use regardless of the level of technological advancement of the port. Because of course, not all ports are on the same technological level. Some may have a higher degree of automatizations, some have a lower degree of automatizations. Of course, it is desirable to use the sensors and IoT wherever possible, but sometimes it's simply not possible. For example, one of our eKPIs is noise pollution. It is desirable to use noise sensors, but in the case it is impossible, we can use some periodical measurements that most countries require entities such as ports to do in some periodical intervals. Also, we needed to have in mind that it should be usable for use in other ports, not only our four pilot ports. So that's why we needed to keep in touch with the available literature, both scientific and other reports, because if we concentrate only to opinions of our four pilot ports, that are of course very useful, but we could end with having only those aspects that are significant in those four ports, and maybe some significant aspects in other ports would be omitted by that procedure. And also one issue that is related to the level of technological advancement is that we have different acquisition methods in each of the port. It can be related to technological advancement, but it can also be a case-by-case issue, because not all ports use the same acquisition method for every, let's say, aspect or environmental key performance indicator. So with those obstacles or issues, I will conclude my part, and I will now pass the stand to our colleague Orestis from CERT. He will tell you more about the current status of environmental monitoring and provide you some further information. So I don't know if there are any questions, would you ask it at the end or now? It's both is fine for me.
If there are no questions at the moment, I will proceed. Thank you, Stepan. I'm Orestes Tsolakis. I'm a research associate at CERT. And from my side, I would also like to welcome all the participants to our webinar today. Let me just share my screen. Now, in my presentation, I will provide you with some results and conclusions from an activity which was performed in the context of PEI development. It had to do with capturing and recording the current status of the environmental performance monitoring by the 10T ports. Now, why this activity was considered to be important? We wanted to do this because we need to have a clear view of the environment in which the PEI solution will be implemented in terms of the current environmental monitoring and the sharing of the results by ports. And also we wanted in this way to create a collection of the current metrics used today in order to verify that the PEI solution is aligned to the port needs, meaning that we wanted to be sure that it includes all the main and important aspects of environmental behavior of ports. Another important objective was to check the availability of data, because PEI as a tool, as a solution, is building on metrics that are already performed by ports. It's also targeting small and medium ports, which means that it wants to use all the available data that already is there and exists in order to be more feasible for smaller and medium ports to implement it. Now, beside these two very important matters, we also wanted to see which are the problems today, the problems that ports have in implementing such type of metrics, not necessarily composite indexes like PEI, but in general in all environmental metrics, and in sharing the results from these metrics. And finally, one very important aspect, which is the use of benchmark by ports in order to place themselves with regard to their behavior, environmental behavior, to place themselves among the other ports. Now, to do this, we used three main methods. The one had to do with analyzing the published environmental reports, which was free available at the websites of 10T ports. We collected all these reports and analyzed their content. And the second and third had to do with performing a survey through a questionnaire, coupled with some online interviews with selected ports and their representatives, in order to provide us some insight in the ports' problems and their methods for sharing the results. Now, as for the analysis of the environmental reports, we total collected 63 reports, which covered 86 of the 10T ports. It's about one third of the total number of 320 10T ports. And as for the current, the comprehensive ports, we had about 40% coverage of the core ports and 20% coverage of the comprehensive ports. So these reports was distributed among the majority of the European countries which are part of the 10T network. As you can see, the reports of the reports from Spain are the majority of reports. This is because of an obligation that from the state that Spanish ports have to report and publish these reports. So this was very helpful to get an insight into the metrics that are performed, especially from Spanish ports. But as you can see, there are many reports from many other different countries. Now, as for the results from this analysis, first of all, the categories, the main categories which were recorded and were applied by the European ports. As for the measuring the environmental impact, it's included the quality of air, the concentrations of pollutants, but also the emissions from pollutants. The waste, either these come from the port land operations and the wastewater that is produced there, either from ships according to the MARPOL categories, the dredging operation, and also the environmental incidents which happen at the port areas. Regarding the consumption of resources, energy and water, of course, are mostly measured, followed by the consumption of various materials and the land use. The land use is especially included in the report published by Spanish Ports. In my next slide, I have the five most common metrics that we found. You will see that three of these metrics refer to consumption of electricity, fuel, and water, while the other two, the one is related to the emissions of greenhouse gases, and the noise, which appears to be a very important issue for ports. Now, what was the conclusion from these results, from the analysis? First of all, we verified that the eKPIs which are used in the PEI are totally aligned to the needs of ports, because more or less the PEI captures what the ports, the majority of ports, are already trying to measure. And the second one has to do with my next slide. This is two pages from the report which was submitted, in which we can see that regarding air quality, the indicators used for each one of the metrics, let's just say for nitrate oxides, we have many different indicators and units for measuring the same thing. This is a very important conclusion, because it shows that there is a great lack of standardization, which in turn creates problems in making comparisons outside the port, meaning that one port can compare itself with himself regarding the previous year, as for his behavior in some pollutants, let's say. But it's very difficult to compare itself to other ports, because they use different indicators, different units, measuring approximately the same thing compared to other ports. So this is one very important conclusion from this work. Now, moving on to the questionnaire survey and the online interviews results, and the main problems we found in the introduction of port environmental impact measurement system, we found that the two main problems which are mostly highlighted by the participants are, in terms of significance, are the lack of standardized list of metrics and the lack of an automated data collection, which in fact is the value proposition of PEI, which targets in these two things exactly, which is to provide a standardized method of collecting all the metrics and the majority of cases through an automated Internet of Things way. So this is also very important regarding the PEI. As for the methods of sharing results, what we can see in this slide is that in the majority of cases, the sharing of the results is made mainly by the sustainability reports, which we already collected, we have collected and analyzed, and through some ad hoc meetings, mainly with the stakeholders which are particularly interested in specific metrics, such as the noise or the emissions. What we can see in this table and the conclusion from this this survey was that overall there is a problem which ports have in communicating their results. And also this is another important thing that PEI has to offer, being a composite metric which includes many different aspects of the environment. It can help ports be more communicating easier the results and their environmental awareness to the society. Now, I will finish my presentation with the last but very important conclusion and the result from our work, which had to do with the benchmark used by ports. What we found is that in the A vast majority of ports which participate in the questionnaire and also to the online interviews, there is not a clear way of placing themselves among other ports in terms of environmental behavior. They try to find ways, they all try to find ways to compare themselves either through reading the reports from other ports or more general reports from the port community, from the port system of their country, collecting information from newsletters or magazines from other ports, but there is not one robust and unique way as a benchmark which is widely used in order to assess their environmental behavior. So this, I believe, is an equally important conclusion from this work. Now, I will stop right here, and now we'll pass. I don't know if there are any questions that you would like me to answer now or at the end. If there are no questions, I will now pass the floor to my colleague from UPB Nacho, who will provide you with some information regarding the visualization of PEI.
Thank you, Orestes, for your presentation and for the kind introduction. Should I just proceed and share my screen, Leonidas?
Yes, please, Nacho. Go ahead.
Great. I don't know if it's seeable already.
Yes, it is to me.
Great. Thank you very much. Thank you to my colleagues for their presentations just before me. And I sincerely hope you have had a proper grasp of what our port environmental index is or has been in its design and implementation phase, at least in the theoretical and contextualized part. Before digging a little bit deep into what it has become in terms of a tool, I would like to say that we will be explaining in detail the tool itself in architectural terms and in technical provision terms later on this year, actually, specifically on 28th September, when we will hold our final closure event of the project that it's finishing on 30th September, by the way. And there you will have the opportunity to know much more details in technical terms than the ones I'm going to provide today. With that said, let me use this slide for contextualizing a little bit what's port environmental index within pixel technological provision. As you may have learned by now, drawing from the previous webinars, Pixel is an IoT platform that has been specifically designed for small and medium ports. So having the barriers, convenience, and hindrances of small and medium ports in Europe in mind, for providing additional added value services on top of data to be gathered from heterogeneous data sources. In that context, the Port Environmental Index is a model, an application, a functionality, a tool that builds on certain processes of data gathering. As my colleagues have explained, the data gathering process for the Port Environmental Index is based on one concept that we define called environmental KPIs, that are no other than single data collection items that aim at representing one specific origin attributable to environmental impact of a port in a certain domain and from a certain entity participating in a port, meaning the port authority, the terminal, the ships, or globally attributable to the port, and divided in different categories, emissions, waste, wastewater, as my colleagues have said. Technologically, this follows a couple of flows that are here more or less depicted in these images that to sum up consist on gathering the data sources through what we call NGSI agents that are pieces of software that are able to retrieve the data from their raw format in the original data source, convert it to the proper format based on a periodicity and based on agreed data models aligned with the current trends on the open community of IoT development. This data is managed through a context broker. In Pixel, we selected Fiber Orion, that is a building block of the Constructing a Europe Facility enabler building block. And after that, all the data, according to the data model selected and the periodicity agreed, is stored in a global persistence database that we call Information Hub. It's one of the products we have developed in Pixel platform. And this data is utilized by the Port Environment Index model that retrieves the data, uses the data from the database to construct the Port Environment Index, which is a composite indicator subdivided or formed by sub-indexes assigned to the ships, to the terminals, or to the port authority attributable impacts into the environment. This model is nothing but a series of mathematical operations, statistical operations such as normalization, weighting, aggregation, consolidation of the data, aimed at building this renowned environmental indicator as the port environmental. As I have said, all this process will be, let's say, more explained, showcased to you later on this year in September. So I would like to advance to the next slide in where I am giving you some pills of what the user interface is of the Port Environmental Index. That at the end of the day is what the port stakeholders will be seeing or looking at or using for applying some decisions and checking the temporal evolution, etc. In this slide, there is an overall view, an overall aspect look of what the Port Environmental Index tool looks like. You can see it's composed of various, say, parts or spans of a dashboard that can be navigated, selected by the user, and providing different types of information that I will explain later. The tool is integrated within the Pixel provision, the Pixel dashboard, the user interface of the whole platform solution of the project, and it's provided to the user in a web interface fashion. So it can be used with any web browser, including mobile devices. So, after looking at the overall aspect of the Port Environmental Index provision, what the port will be able to see and how this will be provided to them, I would like to show you a little bit of which parts is this tool composed of, what we have called the art of interpretation, because of course, Port Environmental Index provides certain amount of information that without the proper tool for interpreting it, it's of no value, of course. First, the Port Environmental Index has this evolution temporal line tracking to check the evolution of the different indices in time. The example you are seeing here is showing the evolution of whole 1 year. Needless to say, this graph is extendable, can be, say, constrained to a specific set of time, to a whole year, to every time frame selected, and it shows four different lines that are corresponding to the PEI as a global number, let's say as the single indicator that is looked for, and the other three, the other four are subdivided into the categories. SEI, the ship, the terminal, port authority, global environmental indicator, so that in case that any particular stakeholder would be looking at this tool would be able to just take a look to the only interesting graph that's interesting or attributable to them and make actions upon them and check how it has evolved and let's say pinpointed or assimilated or corresponded to certain events happening on the port or certain investments done to correct or to improve the environmental impact, also to check that it corresponds to a specific peaks of the freight load or volume in one sense or the other, etc. So that's the first dashboard that can be seen. Second, and let's say the most wrapping up, it's the port environmental index itself. As it can be seen, it's provided as a gauge meter interpretation, kind of the car velocimeter gauge meter, in which it can be seen how well or how bad are the port performing in terms of environmental towards the impact towards the environment. As close as number one, it's better, and as close as number zero, is the worse. However, here it's good to analyze also the second smaller gauge metric that's attached to the port environmental index value, because to compare, for example, two ports or even two moments of time, it's not enough with just one number between zero and one. Because as my colleagues have commented before me, the heterogeneity, the variety, and the different ways of tackling the obtention of this index are wide and say modally. So in order to interpret that value, we consider or we deem interesting and necessary to attach to the index a value that we call the IoT readiness, reliability rate, has various names, that aims at representing how accurate is that index between 0 and 1 of that specific period. If it's not the same, if one port is providing certain information regarding, for instance, the wastewater disposed or the waste disposed by ships a certain amount of time, if it's introduced or typed manually through a form by the operator, it's not the same that if it's, for example, gathered automatically from the MARPOL and exist forms that are, say, issued by the vessels when arriving at the port. So it's much more trustworthy, the second option. So in order to represent those accuracy acumens, we created this second attached index to be attached to the port environment. The third representation, which is a useful one as well, is the ranking between ports. What does this mean? All ports that will have the port environmental index installed and running will have this tool that aims at positioning them among the ports that are implementing the port environmental index without, of course, disclosing any kind of information. One port will only know at which position it is standing in comparison to the others, but without knowing who are the others, who is first, who is second, or who is in any position, so respecting any kind of privacy issues. For doing this, it's worth to say to stop and reflect that we have made and built the index considering always normalized values, both in amount of cargo processed by the port in a moment of time, and to be normalized between 0 and 1, so that for the values to be comparable and to establish this ranking, everything in the eKPIs value is normalized to tonnage process of cargo and between 0 and 1. And fourth, this kind of polar coordinates circle aims at, for a certain period of time to be selected in that selectable, clearly indicate between 0 and 1 which was the values not of the port environmental index, neither for its sub-index attributable only to ships or waste, or ships or terminals or port authority, but the specific values normalized between 0 and 1 of its eKPI in that period. So it's it considered, from our point of view, a very valid information for a port to realize at which area is the port underperforming or performing well, and to take actions upon this information. And last but not least, the explanation I've made about this attached index for understanding the accuracy of the environment of the indicator, it also generates a table in which it can be, let's say, broken down and dissected for each particular data source provision, so that you can track down why this readiness rate is 54% or 75%, and at which part it could be changed or improved for increasing that rate. For instance, we could go to this specific table and check, okay, I am falling short specifically in the noise gathering form because I am just putting some data in the platform, and if I would say upgrade to including that data through a sensor into the platform, I could improve my rates and my port environmental index would be much more trustworthy, and I could just show it better to the community or to whoever. So in a glance, these are the features that have been included, and these are how they will be visualized, and how they are actually being visualized in the pixels port environmental index executions. Thank you, and this is the thing that I have for today. I also encourage again all of you to attend on September to the final event. Thanks.
Thank you very much, Nacho. Before we start the Q&A session, I must inform you that Orestes had to go to take a COVID test. He had an appointment at 12, and we didn't expect the webinar presentation to last this long. In any case, if anybody has any question, please go ahead and ask now. Yes, I have one question. Seeing all this very nice presentation, I'm seeing that you are taking a great deal in convincing the ports by taking various measures in order to accept this port environmental index and all the work you have done. In general, how are you expecting this PEI to compare among the ports?
I would like to answer this question. Well, we had two more slides in the presentation, but given that we already late, we don't have to show them, but one, it was answered there. So the PEI gives insight and an extensive documentation coming from the PEI should be really valuable to all the ports. And given that we are trying to be greener, and the European narrative is to be a greener port, to greener policies, PEI should help the port in the decision-making process in this narrative, among other things, and comparing to other ports as well.
Are you expecting this to... I understand that this comparison is going to be more or less anonymized between the ports. Am I correct?
Yes, of course. So you will only see your PEI results and in the ranking. There will be no names or no other private information from other ports in the app. So you will only know your own ranking compared to other ports that are named port 1, port 2, or any other name, but no names and no personal information will be there.
Is there were there any impediments that you encountered during this? What were the main obstacles that you found during this PEI elaboration, the construction and the implementation of this one?
Definitely, because it's new, there wasn't anything before that we could look up to, so we had to improvise a lot in the beginning and try to find solutions. And the biggest problem was data retrieval of all of the problems, for the methodology part, of course. So we had to find other ways to calculate the PEI without data where it wasn't possible to get it in some ports, as all ports are different and some ports don't have access to the data we need for the calculation. So we made some approximations for those data which wasn't available.
Thank you. So if there are no other questions, I would like to thank you all for attending this webinar. I would like to thank the presenters for a very interesting and very nice presentation. I will remind again that we will be having an event in the September. And that being said, I want to wish every one of you to enjoy your summer and any vacations you might have.
Great. Thank you, Leonidas, for you, and thank you all for attending.
Thank you. Thank you. Goodbye.
Thank you very much. Bye.